Hey guys, I'm Kamoto Jio, and today I want to talk about the new support abilities added to Japan, and also the new raid boss changes. I think it's a pretty big changes to a lot of units. I just want to talk a bit about these changes. First, we're going to talk. I have here side. I'm going to have side to side for the ones I can translate myself. The Reddit translations, because Reddit doesn't have a lot of the old roller recruits, so I want to talk about them too. This is like the list of the important new characters list. The first one is B1 Reilly, which gets an amazing support. He supports Luffy only, and when you get hit by Bind, Despair or Paralysis, you clear 2 turns of Bind, Despair and Paralysis. This is an absolutely amazing support. It's similar to Corazon, but for Luffy, and Luffy, there's a lot of useful Luffys. There's Luffy Lau. Luffy Lau can also use Corazon, but there's Kung Fu Luffy, there's Snake Man, etc, etc, etc. There's a lot of good Luffys, and this really is one of the best supports ever made. Next we have Vege, which we knew what he was going to do, but I kinda knew he was not going to support a lot of units. I thought he was going to support his batch, and not even that, only one characters. Vege, he supports Chiffon, and when you use the special of the supported character of Chiffon, you negate all damage like for 1 turn, like Legend Robin. This makes Chiffon is already a very useful character, and this makes her even more useful, but you basically have to carry a unit just to have the Legend Robin effect, so unless you need Chiffon utility, you don't really mind about carrying Robin or carrying Chiffon with Vega support. Okay, next we have Ace. This is one of the most useless units in the game, and now it's one of the most useful, guys. Because these days, on the final stage, when you get to the final stage, he boosts the quick affinity, the affinity for quick characters, by 1.3 for 1 turn. Which is similar, basically, to Raid Zoro. Raid Zoro is amazing support, this is a lot of play, and this is for a full color, it's not for only a class, it's for a full color. And if you can use this Ace as a support, it means you already have a quick character that benefits from the affinity. That's another amazing support, guys. Okay, next we have Lock Luffy. He supports all the Straw Hats except Brook, Jinbe, etc. When you get to the final battle, you convert the slot of the supported character to Strange and makes Strange orbs matching for 1 turn. Also very, very good support. Honestly, Snake Man is good, but Snake Man is just stats. This Luffy brings utility, and making Strange matching for 1 turn can be very useful. Honestly, it's a shame because I think Akainu B1 wanted this, and now Akainu B1 Plus doesn't need it anymore. Next we have Kuma. He supports Mori and Perona, and when you receive a Despair effect, you remove 5 turns of Despair. This is another crazy support, guys. 5 turns of Despair is pretty beast, guys. Pretty beast. When you receive 5 turns of Despair, you remove 5 turns of Despair the first time, obviously. Yeah, Garp. I'm going to read here. Garp or no, Sengoku. Sengoku supports Garp. And obviously these abilities are all at max level, guys. And you remove 1 turn of Despair and attack down when you receive a Despair or attack down. Amazing. It's like simply amazing on a support. You need to carry a Garp. There's not a crazy amount of Garps useful. There's Legend Garp. There can be options to use this Garp support, guys. This Sengoku support, guys. Okay, next we have Chiffon. She supports Vege, and when you use a special, the special of Vege, any Vege, you heal 20% of my HP, and you put the orb of Vege to matching. Basically, this is amazing because when you use Vege special, you lose all your HP, and you recover 20% HP with Chiffon special, and also put his orb to matching, which is pretty good, guys, pretty good. Okay, and these are the characters which are not recommended. Are not, but it's all the characters. Okay, Sengoku or dear Sengoku, the best legend in the game, guys. This is the best character and it needs the best support. He supports characters with 29 cost or less, and when you use the character special, he boosts their damage by 2.5 for one turn. It says two times on Game with, but on Reddit they say it's 2.5, so I will believe Reddit. 2.5 for characters with a cost of 29 or less. Better to have it than to not have it, but not really need it. Okay, Crocodile on several characters, 9% stats to the basic stats of supported characters. This is good, not a priority, but if you have extra support items, 9% stats to a single class is good. Okay, then we have Inuarashi, which supports Caterpillar, I don't know, let me see. Inuarashi, I think I have it around here. I don't know exactly who is, I think maybe Slasher? I think it's maybe Slasher, probably Slasher. Okay, Inuarashi is like Weevil, basically puts 130 his attack as tap timing damage for 2 turns on the character, only on the supported character. It's good to have, nothing crazy still. I don't use Weevil too much as a support, but it's still good. Okay, next we have God Enel, Kami Enel. He supports quick characters, reduces the damage you receive from strange enemies by 5% and adds 20% his recovery to the base recovery of the supported characters. This is good if you want to use Marco or something in another team that doesn't use Enel, because you can use Enel to support Enel. It's a shame, but that would be broken as fuck, honestly. It's a good support, but not a crazy priority. Next we have Gear 3 Luffy, the original legend that was not a legend. He supports, again, all the Straw Hats except Brook, RIP Brook, or White. Brook is already RIP. What can we say? This is another character that adds tap timing to the character at the start of the final battle. They add 150 times their attack, 1 second, for one turn. So I think it's better to have the stat boost from Snake Man, but if you don't have a Snake Man, could be good, could be cakeward, could be. Okay, next we have Apu. For Dex characters, when you get to the last stage, he converts their orbs to Dex. This looks small, but this is converting orbs on support. It's pretty interesting because remember that supports avoid enemies' triggers, and they happen at the start of the after the start of the turn, basically. So they avoid preemptives. Obviously, if you have block orbs, you won't be able to convert your slot to Dex, but you can convert it on any other case, and that's really good, guys. Bonnie, the same, basically, but for PSI characters, she converts their orb to meat. Can be nice, can also be nice, guys. Don't sleep on these abilities because they can be useful in certain situations. Okay, next we have the Calvin Brothers, I think. The Calvin Brothers, yes. They support White Veronese. They add 11% of their attack. They probably don't have a lot of attacks, so they probably are not that worth versus White Veronese. And they are just stat boosters. I will say no. Simply no. We have a Strong World Robin. He supports all the Straw Hats this time, including Brook. She adds 9% of her attack and recovery to the supported character. Not bad. I don't know how her stats are, but not bad. If you don't have a lot of better supports for those characters, why not? Then we have a 3D2-year Robin, sorry. Now 3D2-year Chopper. 15% recovery to the same units. Recovery is like, it's worse. Sanji, 3D2-year Sanji, Tunami, Robin, Ivankov, and Elizabeth. He adds 9% of his attack strength to the base attack strength and basic health, attack and health to the attack and health of the supported character. It's not bad, but there's, I think, B2 Sanji is better. Not bad if you don't have anything better. Can be good, but not crazy. 3D Tier Luffy, which supports every Straw Hat, including Jinbe and Rayleigh, which is not a Straw Hat, adding 7% of their status to the status of the supported characters. Snake Man exists. If you have a Snake Man, if you don't have a Snake Man, it might be good to have this Luffy as a support. If not, if you have him, no, not really. Okay, next we have 3D Tier Usopp, which supports all the Straw Hats and Heracles. 50% health of the basic health of the character. The support is good, but you might not use it at all too much. Okay, then we have Violet, Yellow Violet. She supports Sanji, Flamingo and Treble at 7% stats. Again, there's probably a lot of better supports, and 7% is not a great deal on this unit that probably has shitty damage, shitty attack and HP. Ideo supports Sai, Rudin, Xin Zhao, Bartolomeo and Cavendish, 11% attack. Again, the same, it's just a stat boost. The same for Luffy, 3D2 Strong World Luffy, the same for Sanji, the same for Nami, 3D2 Year, the same for Brook, the same for Zoro, Chopper, Robin, Usopp, Frankie. They are all stat boosters. Can be useful, they boost health or attack. It's nothing crazy, guys. There's a lot of better Straw Hat supports than these guys. The Straw Hat units are not as good. The Straw Hat, Strong World and 3D 2 year Straw Hats. Then we have Tsuru. She supports Garp Sengoku for 12% attack and recovery. I think Tsuru doesn't have very good stats, so probably not a good support at all. Then we have Time Skip Usopp, Time Skip Robin, also stat boosters, nothing crazy. This is Limited Rare Creek Koala, 11% attack to fighters, can be interesting, but it's another stat boost at the end. Usopp, which adds 7% status to Shooter, Limited Rare Creek Usopp, nothing crazy. We enter in the TM units territory, guys. Mihawk, to slashers, 11% of their attack to slashers. That's pretty good, because Legend Mihawk deals 9% of the total stats, but a lot of times, just with attack, you are happy, and this Mihawk actually boosts more attack than Legend Mihawk, which is very crazy. White Bear supports Ace, Marco, Joshua, and Vista, 11% of their attack to the stats of supported characters. Not bad to have. If we get a way to level up TM units support easily, it can be good. Ace, Luffy and White Bear, 8% stats, basically, 8% stats to Luffy and White Bear. Can be good, but probably if you have a lot of supports, not really. Cavendish, to driving units, 9% attack and recovery. Same, it's just a stat booster. These guys are all stat boosters. Gear for Luffy to Freedom, 8% stats. Crocodile to Strikers, 9% attack. Sabo to Cerebrals, 5% health and recovery. Izaru to Dex characters, 50% recovery. This actually can be pretty good for Corazon. Still, recovery is not a very big amount, but Big Mom, Katakuri, Perosperos, Multicracker, 8%, but if you have Legend Big Mom, you don't need it. Enel to PSI, 9% attack and recovery. Jack to Powerhouse, 50% health. Can be useful. Fredo, Shanks to Free Spirit, Lao to Slashers, Stats, Nami to Int Units, 15% recovery. Okay, Kobe and Helmepo from the start of the story, 10% recovery, 10% stats. These are all stats boosters. I'm not going to stop until I see a special effect. Yeah, that's basically the special effect, guys. So as you can see, a lot of these guys are stats boosters, which might not be crazy to bad to have, but it's nothing crazy to use your supports on. The best ones are like on the top here. These are the best ones that you want to use. Okay, and lastly, guys, I'm going to talk about the rights. The changes. Japan changed a lot of the basic rights that no one uses anymore to try to make them better, more interesting. Okay, Chopper, right Chopper. It's a special, no, also boost strength characters by 175. I wish this happened at the start of the game. Maybe not useful now, maybe useful depending on your box of free to play players. Blackbeard, his captain ability no boost strength characters by 275 before it was 2.5 and their HP by 2.5 which was 225. Still doubles damage taken and special now does 20 times damage received last turn type plus damage to all enemies. You're not going to use Blackbeard, guys. I got it when he was semi-new and I never used him, guys. Kizaru just got a captain ability boost. You're not really going to use Kizaru or ride Kizaru as a captain. Same for Boa. You're not really going to use Boa as captain. As a sub, yeah. Okay, Momonga, 275 to Cerebral. No, really, no. There's way better things. Garp, his captain ability now boost PSI characters by 2.5 and rate speed by 2. I think it was 2 attack only. And the special also boosts PSI character odds by 175, probably. Nothing crazy. Heracles actually got interesting because he got a captain ability change. You're not going to use his captain ability. And his special locks slots for one turn. This is a huge thing for Jinbe, guys. Yeah, Jinbe exists. Jinbe is a legend that can probably clear a lot of shit. And with Heracles, you can basically have his the orbs that Jinbe wants for two turns. That's so big, guys. That's so big for Jinbe. I don't really care about Jinbe, but maybe some guys do. And Ivankov got a boost on the captain ability. No, you're not going to use him as captain. And his special makes strength sticks and quick beneficial for one turn. Maybe useful in some situation, but probably not. And for Nightmare Luffy, we don't know what has changed yet. Okay, so there's not a lot of crazy things that you will use, but maybe free-to-play players will appreciate more all these changes. And there's quite a few good supports happening in this patch. So I think overall, it's a pretty good patch, guys. It's a pretty good list of changes. So yeah, I'm going to wrap it up here, guys. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you liked it, and I hope to see you on the next one.